Mike, if you question, you got time?
Sorry, man.
Mike, what brings you out here, man?
Fights, good fights, man. Great fights tonight.
Yeah, what do you think happens in this fight, man? Vargas Salido?
Tough guys, man. Both of them are very tough guys. Salido keeps coming. Salido happens to always win the fights he's supposed to lose.
Yeah.
So I wouldn't count him out.
Yeah.
But being, you know, that I from what I see, I think Vargas pulls it off.
Yeah.
I think Vargas pulls it off. I think maybe even hurts a little, maybe stops him, but
yeah.
It won't be easy. It won't be a tough fight.
Mike, as for you, man, Vita confirmed to me that Mayweather made a second visit down there to the RGPA. Talk to us a little bit about that.
He wanted to stop by before he went on home to Vegas just to say hi to a couple guys and talk to my brother about other fighters that he's trying to, you know, get on with his promotion. Talk to me a little bit about what he, you know, kind of wants to do and how he feels he can help me. And, we didn't get into that much detail, but it's pretty good. It's looking good.
Frankie, Mikey, this new friendship, do you think it'll eventually lead to deeper negotiations with
it could.
Team?
It could. If it's right and it's right business for me and a right business for him, then we could do something. But as of right now, we still don't have anything officially signed. Nothing is done. There's no agreement. Right now, I'm still here waiting. I'm actually invited here by Golden Boy, and I was also invited by Fernando Beltran. They also want to speak to me a little bit, you know, have an opportunity, and I'm here to, I'm open to talk to anybody. You know?
How do you take to his admiration for you guys and his want of wanting to sign you, make you a pay-per-view star?
That's,
man, he's
cool.
Acknowledged that your dad, you know, your brother Robert, you know, he praises you guys as
That's
a family.
Cool,
you know,
because you know, for him, you know, the kind of guy that he is. You know, he recognizes or sees something in us, in the team, myself, my dad, my brother, you know. And for him to be very interested in working together and being, you know, partners or you know, somehow working together is great. I mean, that shows that we are doing something right, you know. We must be doing something right.
Mikey, as a Mexican and you, man, it seems like maybe you guys are the only ones to always give Mayweather the benefit of the doubt. We always give him positive criticism. And us as Mexicans, man, we always give him the tough criticism. You know, the rest of us, why do you think we give him a tough time, man? We always criticize him, ridicule him. And
some of it is because when fans, especially Latinos, Mexican fans, they want to see a big brawl. They want to see, you know, knockdowns and knockouts. And Floyd is not that fighter. Floyd is a boxer, a technical boxer who boxes very defensively. You know, he doesn't give the fan-friendly fights that people want to see.
Yeah.
I, along with my dad, we give Floyd all the credit.
You guys recognize that his skill level.
We recognize that the skill level is way beyond, you know, what other fighters have or what other fighters offer.
Yeah.
His intelligence, his speed, his reflection, you know, just the reflex and the defense, it's just superb. It's amazing. So we give him credit for that. It's a lot easier for two guys to get in there and bang it and you know, get beat up.
Just like we're expected to see today in the Vargas and
Salido. Today's gonna be a great fight, great show. But with Floyd making most all his fights look easy against world champions and hardly losing a single round, and he's done so much. He's done a lot. You gotta admire. You gotta you know, give him credit.
If not McGregor, man, if not Pacquiao rematch, looks like Danny Garcia is the most likely candidate for Mayweather's return, man. What do you take to that possible matchup for Mayweather to return and give him the opportunity to step into the ring with him?
If it's Danny, I mean, it'll be a good fight because Danny's going to come to fight. He's tough. He's going to come swing. He's going to try to hurt Floyd. But based on Floyd's abilities, I think Floyd picks him apart and just wins the easily decision.
Yeah. You know? Danny seems to have the will, man, the will to always manage to find a way to win, even though people always sometimes criticize the outcome of the fight. They question it, but he always finds a way to win. What do you think will be different with him stepping into the ring with Mayweather from the other
opponents? He's going to keep coming. He's going to try to win every single round, and he's going to try to win you know, the fight till the very last round. But Floyd is not going to let him. Floyd's just going to outbox him. And you know, just win him, you know, win the fight and just beat him on point, you know, decision.
Yeah, as for you, Mike, is it 135 or 140 that you're gonna step back into when?
I want to do 140 for my return for one fight. Then if I can come down to 135, if I feel comfortable after my first return fight, if I feel comfortable and you know making the attempt to 135, I want to get a title 135. eventually moving back up to 140 and campaigning there.
Yeah. I don't know if you've been asked, man, but what do you take to Canelo's decision to vacating the WBC 160 title, man? A lot of people are giving him tough criticism for it, but what's your take on the whole situation, Canelo and Golovkin, and all that?
I know it's a business decision that he vacated the title, but yeah, people don't like it, you know. Yeah.
Why do you think that?
Because
you think
it has anything
to do with what he said post?
Exactly. That's exactly why.
Yeah.
He said this and then does the opposite. I get it's the business that does it, but it just looks bad.
Yeah.
I think the best thing for him to do would have been to vacate the title right after beating Cotto.
And I'll say what he said.
Just announcing, what, I'm vacating the title. I wanted the Cotto fight. The title came along with the fight. Congratulations to me. I went on the title, but I'm vacating the title. I'm not a middleweight. That's what we fought at a catchweight, and that's why I'm coming back down to 154, and there's the title. Sorry, guys, that's it. But instead, he chose to fight Khan, who was a smaller guy, defend the title against Khan.
Yeah.
And then when the negotiations are being forced upon him to fight Triple G, he decides to vacate. It just looks bad.
Yeah.
I understand the business, and he did the right choice for the business side. You know, he made over $20 million probably on Khan. He could fight some other guy, make another 10, 15 million. Next year, fight another guy for 10, 15 million, and then fight Triple G. The business is great.
Yeah.
Whether he does that, he'll make, you know, another, you know, 40 million or 50 million by the time he fights Triple G.
Yeah.
Or he takes Triple G, tough fight, and makes, you know, only 20 million. What are you gonna do? Take 20 million?
Yeah.
Or you're gonna take 50 million up front first and then get the 20 million with Triple G?
Yeah.
It's money. It's business.
Dude, a lot of people don't give him much of a chance against Golovkin, man. But
he has a chance. He definitely has a chance. He's tough. He's strong. He's a big guy. He's a huge guy. You know, of course he has a chance. Golovkin gets hit too.
Yeah.
Golovkin gets tagged. But it's not gonna be easy for either one. I mean, it's gonna be a tough fight. And I, along with a lot of other fans, I think I favor Golovkin, being that he's more comfortable at that weight. He's been there longer. I think he's more determined. He's hungrier. He's probably has greater passion for it. I don't know. He just looks, you know, meaner in that way. But it won't be easy. It's gonna be a tough fight for both of them.
You think the media plays a role in hyping up Golovkin, the quote unquote monster that he is? You know, a few fighters have told me that, and they've questioned his opposition, you know, his quality, the caliber of it.
He's beat everybody in his division. It's not his fault that his division is not stacked with a lot of, you know, talented fighters like big names. But the guys that he's fought, you know, he's clearly dominated with ease.
Yeah.
You know, and Canelo has had some fights where it's tough for him.
Yeah.
He hasn't dominated some guys like Golovkin always does. But he hasn't had the toughest opposition, you know, the best opposition. But he's still dominating.
Yeah.
And I gotta give him credit for that. I mean, he makes it look easy, you know, and it's not his fault. He's cleared out of the division, clearly, you know, beat every champion out there.
Mike, I spoke to Fernando Vargas. He said when you were young, man, you used to say no to boxing.
I don't want to box. I've told everybody, I never picture myself doing this for a career and being where I'm at. And no, I never.
Why is that? Why you have your brother, your dad? They're great trainers. He's a world champion.
I didn't like it. I mean,
Vita's a trainer too now.
It's in the business, in the family. It's what we know. It's what we grow up learning. But I never pictured myself boxing.
Yeah.
It just happened to be. I mean, I started doing it, and I am where I am now.
Yeah. I mean, and where you are, man, everyone's placing a bid for you. How do you take to that, man? Is that humbling? Is that, how does that feel,
it's,
man? Everyone's pulling one arm.
It's unbelievable. I would never expect it to be this big. I mean,
yeah,
it seems like, you know, I'm more popular and on a higher demand now than I was, you know, when I was world champion.
Yeah.
It's crazy, but it's cool. I mean, I don't get big head or anything. I mean, it's crazy. It's cool. But
did you expect this reception when you came back, or you thought people were gonna forget about you a bit? Because
even though I was out, I've always been around the sport. You know, going to the fights. I spend time, you know, I'm accessible to the fans. So I've always received a lot of love and support from fans.
Yeah.
But I really didn't expect this attention, this high demand for me, you know, from all the big promoters and names in the sport, and I mean, just from all over the place. people calling, wanting to, you know, have an opportunity to talk to me. It's insane.
All right, lastly, Mikey, I got to tell you, man, the late, great Muhammad Ali, man, he's passed at the age of 74 yesterday.
Prayers, and, you know, God bless. And family, you know, prayers to family, Ali family, daughter, family, you know, everybody, because it's sad, you know. We lost a great fighter, you know, great champion. Did great things for the sport, so, you know, prayers to the Ali family.
Do you think that really brings an end to a real era, man, an era where fighters were, like they say, you know, they were willing to step in there with anyone just as long as they were considered to be great after the victory?
There's always going to be great fighters, but from that generation, he's the one that really, you know, changed the sport with the promoting and then the way he fought and, you know, it was a different era, but there'll still be
did you ever get a chance to meet him?
I was able to see from distance but never met him.
Okay, last one. What do you recall, man? Maybe one of your favorite fights or a memory that you saw on television of his that just stands out to you every time you think of Muhammad Ali?
You know, just watching all the fights. I mean, I never watched them live or even, you know,
YouTube,
current,
yeah.
But I've seen YouTube, I've seen the ESPN, the classic,
yeah.
And, you know, all of his fights, you know, mocking the opponents, but backing everything up, you know, making it look easy, you know, moving, you know, like if he was a middleweight, you know, like a welterweight, when he's a heavyweight, you know, you just wouldn't see that hand speed, the footwork, the reflexes, you know, the waist and head movement, just amazing, you know, amazing fighter.
All right, Mikey, tell the fans where to follow you.
Team Mikey Garcia on my Instagram and at Mikey Garcia on Twitter. I, you know, post, I tweet, I retweet, I like, I, you know, I comment.
Yeah.
Just hit up.
It's interactive.
Interactive, yeah.